The chief guest of today's event and the State Minister of Defence, Honourable Ruan Vijayawardena, Admiral of the Fleet, Vasanta Karanagoda, Secretary to His Excellency the President, Mr. Udaya Senaviratna, Secretary to Ministry of Defence, General Shanta Kottegoda, retired, Secretary to Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Ravinath Aryasinghe, Secretary to Ministry of Ports and Shipping, Admiral retired Sirimon Ranasinghe, Excellencies, Chief of Navies, Heads of Delegations, Chief of Defence Staff, Admiral Ravindra Vijayagunaratna, Commander of the Sri Lanka Army, Lieutenant General Shavendra Silva, Commander of the Sri Lanka Air Force, Air Marshal Sumangala Dias, Distinguished Invitees, Officers, Members representing media agencies, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. At the very outset, let me extend my sincere thanks and gratitude to Honorable State Minister of Defense, Admiral of the Fleet, Secretary to His Excellency the President, Secretary to the Ministry of Defense, and the Secretaries to other ministries, Excellencies, Chief of Defense Staff, Command of the Sri Lanka Army and Sri Lanka Air Force for accepting our invitation and being present here today to witness the 10th edition of Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference. I also take this opportunity to welcome all the Chief of Navies and other senior officers representing the Navies and Coast Guard around the globe and wish to extend my heartfelt gratitude for accepting our invitation and enthusiastically participating at this August gathering to share your views and concerns on maritime aspect. Further, let me warmly welcome and express our sincere thanks to all other invitees, especially past Navy commanders, officers of Triforces, senior officials representing various international and local institutions for being present here to add a recognition to this conference. Ladies and gentlemen, today I am very proudly and comfortably standing in front of many distinguished leaders and practitioners of maritime domain to make the opening remarks of the 10th edition of Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference. Let me recall the progress made by the Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference since 2010, which was initiated by then Commander of the Navy, Vice Admiral Tisara Samarasinghe, as the premier international maritime conference in Sri Lanka. The initial conference took place at an opportune time, 1 year after the defeat of the terrorism by the Sri Lankan Defence Forces. The first Galle Dialogue Conference was a landmark event in the history of the Ministry of Defence and the Sri Lanka Navy to unveil such an international conference under the theme of charting the course for sustainable maritime security cooperation. The first Galle Dialogue Conference created a friendly atmosphere and a comfortable venue for us to disseminate hard-learned lessons that other countries could learn from our experiences and provided a forum to exchange information between the participants. I strongly believe that we have collectively achieved our aim by fostering and developing a sustainable maritime security cooperation among key players in the maritime sector. Today, it is clearly evident that there are 148 participants representing 54 countries and 17 international organizations seated in front of me. Ladies and gentlemen, the second and third Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference were held under the banner of Challenges and Strategic Cooperation for Indian Ocean Maritime Concern and Strategic Maritime Cooperation and Partnership to Face the Future with Confidence, respectively. And again, all the participated nations and other stakeholders identified the necessity of establishing cooperation among each other as the best tool to address the maritime challenges. From the fourth Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference up to the one held last year, we rallied together in Colombo to understand various maritime challenges being faced by different nations and discussed various approaches to mitigate the same. Here, I must emphasize that collaborative and cooperative efforts and rule-based order were the key concept highlighted throughout these forums. Ladies and gentlemen, let me draw your attention to a quotation from Robert D. Kaplan's publication, Monsoon. I quote, "Today, despite the jet and information age, 90% of global commerce and 2/3 of all petroleum suppliers travel by sea." I unquote. More shopping demands more shipping. More shipping demands comprehensive security in order to ensure unimpeded sea lanes of communication. Therefore, it is noteworthy that all maritime nations must realize the threats they are facing today. Transnational crimes such as human smuggling, piracy, drug trafficking, maritime terrorism, IUU fishing, and maritime pollution have room to take place because of the lack of adequate domination and surveillance at sea. The increasing number of seagoing vessels and their growing diversity make the identification of potential threats very difficult. Threats also exist in sea lanes of communication, which in turn affect the international trade and energy security. Therefore, countries must get together to find solutions beyond the legal intervention in the high seas, despite of the existence of various conventions, treaties, or agreements, whereas token joint naval exercises are no longer adequate. Furthermore, this forum is facilitating to establish cooperation among nations. This vital forum has always been promoting proper intelligence gathering and timely communication between the navies and other maritime agencies over the last 9 years. Ladies and gentlemen, this conference has reiterated and amply highlighted that no matter how powerful we are individually, as long as we act in isolation, we will be ineffective in mitigating present threats being posed by non-state actors and criminals at sea. Hence, I am certain that understanding, cooperation and collaboration efforts among us will be further enhanced with your dialogue at this conference. Having considered all such discussions, deliberations, arguments and agreements to establish and enhance cooperation, coordination, collaboration and sharing of knowledge, experiences, resources and information among us, this year we have planned to conduct the Galle Dialogue Conference under the theme of refining the mindset to address the transnational maritime threats, a review of the decade, in order to understand how all maritime stakeholders and participants of the Galle Dialogue over the last decade have responded individually or collectively to address transnational maritime threats in the ocean space. Today, I am sure that all the presenters will be presenting their case studies or discussions based on facts, figures, and lessons learned by revisiting the issues that each nation came across during the last few years. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, this forum has the capacity and capability to promote security for regional and global economies by ensuring maritime security through enduring partnerships between civilians and military authorities. Further, through presenting and discussing of own experiences of contemporary maritime issues, this forum will provide a good platform for world navies and other stakeholders to introduce a new perspective to address common maritime issues and extend an opportunity for further establishment of collaborative and cooperative partnership. Nations have developed new capabilities and capacities to meet maritime security challenges over the last decade. Now, I believe time has come to take a positive action, not just discussions. We must be proactive and move ahead. Therefore, I, on behalf of the Ministry of Defence, humbly request all of you to participate effectively in this forum towards achieving our desired goals. In concluding, I wish to mention that we have been able to successfully organize this International Maritime Conference over 9 consecutive years with the guidance and assistance of the Ministry of Defence. I, on behalf of the officers and sailors of the Sri Lanka Navy, wish to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the Ministry of Defence for keeping the trust in us to organize this conference and the support extended to us to make this event a success. Since inception, the Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference has gained the momentum of attending participants from many countries and international agencies, showcasing its growing strength. The Galle Dialogue over the years has contributed immensely to discuss most of the key issues in the maritime domain. I am sure that most of us benefited not only by attending the conference, but also through interaction and bilateral meetings. In particular, Sri Lanka Navy has achieved success in developing partnership with regional and extra-regional navies in the field of modernizing, capacity building, and mitigating common maritime security challenges, especially in the field of drug trafficking, human smuggling, conduct of search and rescue operations, and protecting and preserving of maritime environment whilst ensuring the freedom of navigation for the legitimate seafarers. Ladies and gentlemen, it is in this context genuine cooperation, fostering partnership, and learning of the best practices are some of the key objectives of the Galle Dialogue Maritime Conference. I am certain that the lineup of presentation, panel discussions, and formal and informal interaction taking place during the coming 2 days will be instrumental in this regard. In closing, I wish all the participants a very interesting, thought-provoking, and productive time in this year's conference while enjoying the beauty and serendipity of our country during your short stay. I wish all the very best for participants, moderators, and presenters. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, His Excellency the President Maithripala Sirisena was to attend the inaugural session of Gold Dialogue Conference today as the chief guest. Unfortunately, His Excellency is unable to grace this occasion due to an official overseas visit. However, His Excellency has sent a message to be delivered to this August gathering at the inaugural session. Let me present His Excellency's message now. I am pleased to send this message to the International Maritime Conference, Gold Dialogue 2019, organized by the Sri Lanka Navy in collaboration with the Ministry of Defense on 21st and 22nd October 2019 in Colombo. This conference has a special significance to nations such as Sri Lanka engaged in expansion of maritime activities. The Gold Dialogue Maritime Conference 2019, under the theme of Refining Mindset to Address Transnational Maritime Threats, a Review of the Decade, intends to focus on addressing the future with revised mindset to meet the maritime threats based on the experiences of all stakeholders in the last 10 years. I trust that in this forum, the stakeholders will be invited to present their case studies based on facts and figures with lesson learned and recommendation in preparing for the third decade of the new millennium. To revisit the issues that each stakeholder faced during the last decade would be useful to learn the best practices in addressing, mitigating and curbing the threats posed to the good order of the maritime space in the Indian Ocean. Furthermore, the forum will provide a good venue for the world navies and other stakeholders to discuss operational case studies in contemporary maritime issues and introduce a new perspective to address common maritime issues as well as explore possibilities of further strengthening collaboration and expanding cooperative partnership. I wish the Gold Dialogue every success. Maithripala Sirisena, the President, Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. Thank you very much.